The thing that's most important for consumers to know about plants or products developed using genetic engineering is that we have a wide variety of federal agencies who evaluate these products to ensure that they are safe. My name is Bernadette Wattis. I am the Deputy Administrator for the Biotech Program at USDA. I lead a team of scientists and professionals who are responsible for reviewing agriculture plants developed using genetic engineering.
I think the most important thing consumers need to know about the new varieties of plants, and then some people call these GMOs, is that FDA is on the job. My name is Dennis Keefe. I recently retired from FDA. I was the office director for the Office of Food Additive Safety for over 10 years before I retired.
I think one of the most important things that people should know about GMOs is that these are modified in very specific, precise ways intentionally. My name is Amanda Pierce, and I'm a biologist here at EPA, where I look at different types of genetically modified plants and organisms, and I evaluate them for the safety of the environment. The EPA works along with FDA and USDA to regulate GMOs. And what the EPA does in particular is we're looking at these pesticidal products. And so we look at it from a couple different angles. There's the human health and safety angle, where we're looking at whether or not these products are safe to eat. And then there's also the environmental angle, where we're looking at whether or not these products can be safe in the environment in terms of plants and animals. And to do this, we do rigorous risk assessments to ensure that safety.
FDA regulates GMOs by running a consultation program with industry, where industry presents a dossier of information on the safety of their new varieties, and we evaluate that information.
We evaluate plants developed using genetic engineering to ensure that they are as safe from a plant health perspective and an environmental perspective as a plant that has been developed using traditional breeding techniques. We undertake an evaluation of the plant and carefully consider information and evidence to ensure that the plant developed using genetic engineering doesn't present a risk to plant health or agriculturally important resources. One of the things we look at, for example, is where the plant might grow. Is this new plant developed using genetic engineering able to grow in an environment where a similar plant isn't found? And if so, is there a potential impact there?
In terms of the safety of the current GMOs, the new varieties of plants, and I was focusing on the new varieties of plants, I have full confidence in the safety of the new varieties that FDA has looked at and reviewed. In fact, I have seen the dossiers. I have been in meetings with developers of new varieties where we have asked difficult questions, and they've gone back and provided the data and information. I am very confident in the safety of those new varieties.
So you can create a genetically modified organism for a lot of different purposes. And here at EPA, we're looking at ones that have been modified to have certain pesticidal properties. So that's a lot of times plants that have been genetically modified to be able to protect themselves from different insects or different types of diseases. There's a lot of benefits that we have to these insect-resistant GMOs, one of which is that by using these, we're actually able to reduce the use of the conventional chemical pesticides that we're all more familiar with. My family and I eat GMOs all the time. Lots of corn and soybean have been genetically modified, so I think it is very likely that a lot of us eat GMOs quite often.
My family and I eat genetically modified foods in our household.
So I know I eat GMOs because the great majority of soybeans, of corn, it produced in the U.S. are genetically modified from genetically modified plants. I know that. So any of the foods I'm eating that contain soy or corn would all have genetically modified ingredients from genetically modified plants. And I am very confident that those are safe. I have no qualms about eating foods that contain those ingredients.
In terms of eating GMOs, it doesn't cross my mind at all. Also because, you know, I know the people who are performing the risk assessments and what it is that we're looking at in terms of the science, so I don't have any concerns about their safety.